Muskogee, your Academic Office, Wichita. And I also thank Representative Scott for his comments this morning as well. I have with what the administration did is that we really don't know what its intent is with regard to the waiver that they're proposing. And that's why this is Congress's job. The decision by this administration to waive the work requirements is not only bad policy, but it's bad governance. It fails, in my opinion, just like so many of our social entitlement laws do, to honor the idea of earned success. Earned success, the idea that you're creating value with your life and valuing the lives of others. However you want to define that. That you're not living on handouts. And that's why I was so intrigued by the reforms of 1996. Because it required able-bodied persons to work. And that's why I'm so troubled by this administration's decision to waive the work requirements for welfare recipients. That this decision devalues work. It downplays the importance of work to human dignity. In America, we always believed that work was a good thing, that as human beings, we were created to do good work, to create value in our lives and value in the lives of others. We are a nation that is generous to our neighbors, and we help those who are in need. In fact, according to the World Giving Index, Americans are the most generous people in the world. However, we also want to know that each one of us is doing what we can to exercise our personal responsibility, Mr. Chairman, and improve our situation in life. And what this administration is basically saying is that dignity comes, in fact, from the government at their timing and at their pleasure, and not from individuals using their God-given capacity to work. The genius of the 96 welfare reforms is that it acknowledged the destruction caused by an unlimited welfare system that discouraged work and achieved that system so as to promote work. It was tremendously successful, Mr. Chairman, and now the administration wants to take a giant step backward. Not only is this morally wrong and against the entire idea of human dignity and earned success, but what the administration is doing is something that it doesn't even have the legal authority to do. Polls continue to show us that a majority of Americans believe that able-bodied adults receiving public assistance should work while they receive that assistance. A welfare program should only be considered successful if it helps people get off welfare. The reforms put in place in 1996 have done just that. Following the enactment of the 1996 law, the welfare caseload fell by half, employment of single mothers increased by 15%, child poverty in female-headed households fell significantly. But the reforms, before the reforms, the average length of stay on welfare was 13 years. It is now capped at 5 years, and other data for fiscal year 2009 shows that only 1.7% of the case closings that year were due to people maxing out their time on the welfare system. The work requirements have worked. No longer are we giving a handout, we're giving a hand up. And that is why we cannot let this administration undo them. I yield back.